Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. So here we'll take a look why notification sound doesn't work a lot of time, and at the end we'll see why it works in our case. So anyway, so this is the function that I'm calling to show notification as well as the sound. So wherever we call it from, we send this basic information, and in your case you might just want to send title and body. This could be optional for you. You can skip that. And at the same time, maybe we are passing Flutter local notification plugin object, but this object could be global for you, so it doesn't really matter. Now over here, a lot of time, this is not important once again, so you can skip that. Most important part for showing and to be able to hear the sound of notification, you have to call this one, which is called Android notification details. This is a function that's inside this Flutter local notification plugins. Just go ahead and call them. Now over here, the channel name is very important. So a lot of time your app could have bug, or where as you work with the sound, the channel name stays the same. But the idea is, as you solve the bug, as you try to listen to the sound, a lot of time it might not work first time. So each time you make a change, especially for listening to the sound, you should change the channel name. So first time you make a build for listening to the sound, but it didn't work, or there might be other bugs, and you, as you change the code, you also have to change this channel name. It has to be unique during each build. Otherwise, you might get error, and this is at least what happened to me. So eventually what I found, my problem was that this channel name from the very beginning was the same, which I didn't change, and I was changing everywhere, just not this one. So other settings were correct, but what happened later on, this name I didn't change. So at the end I have changed it. So as you can see, I have channel ID 5. Actually previously I started with 1, so I changed it 5 times. So I changed the name to channel ID 5, but this name could be any unique name, okay? Now, once again, this section is not important, which is coming from here. So you can skip that. You don't have to pass anything over here. But one important thing, other important thing is this play sound. It has to be true, okay? And once you make this notification Android platform channel specifics, this object over here, you need to pass it to notification details for the Android object. And once you do that, you are good to go. And then, of course, based on this local notification plugin object, you're going to show and pass this plus platform specific object. So the takeaway is that this has to be unique if you try to have different builds of your APK. And at the same time, I found that in our Android manifest.xml over here, you should change the name as well, okay? Otherwise, you might get errors. So as you change over here, you should change over here as well, and it should work. Okay, now because I was trying on simulator, the notification sound doesn't work, but the notification works, okay? And we have seen it before, but in this case, I'm going to use my real device and show you that it works. So let's go ahead and say it on my real device. Thank you. Okay, so over here we have this backend, and we are going to send notification from our backend. And from here, as we do it, and we'll see that we have a notification over here. Let's go ahead and click on this. Okay, and we see that we have sound. We click on this and it takes us to a new route over here. Now we'll put our app like this on the foreground one more time. Let's go ahead and click on this, and we'll send a notification. And we see that it popped up, and we click on this, it takes us to a new route. So that's how your notification and sound works together. Thank you.